I started playing violin when I was about 4. I realized that I wanted to take this as a career around 6. I think when I was 6 is when I went to go see Itzhak Perlman in concert. I was apparently crying, and I said, you know, it was so beautiful. So, I mean, that was really when I realized that I wanted to be a violinist.
Ninth grader Sage McBride is well on his way to becoming a professional musician. He's concert master for the Miami Music Project Honors Orchestra, which is comprised of the most talented high school and area college students. It's in this orchestra where young musicians are guided by many of South Florida's most accomplished professional musicians.
I'm pretty much James Judd's assistant, kind of, for the orchestra. So I take care of making sure everyone's in sync with the conductor.
So now what I want you to do is think color for the beginning as well, with the vibrato, and think of the darkness of this piece, you know?
The creator and driving force behind the Miami Music Project is James Judd, internationally known British conductor. Maestro Judd, who makes his home in South Florida, was music director of the Florida Philharmonic for 14 years.
Our priority is not to find the next Perlman, you know, but of course, coincidentally, through this activity, you find and nurture kids that are willing to put the 10,000 hours into becoming the next Perlman, you know. So there will be great talent that emerges.
10th grader Troy Duffy is timpanist for the Honors Orchestra. He's yet another musician who's thriving under the guidance of the Miami Music Project.
I've been playing drum set in church for as long as I can remember. And I started playing percussion maybe 3 years ago, 2-3 years ago. I haven't been sight reading music long, and I don't know, I just have a knack for it. It pushes me.
The Honors Orchestra is but one component of the entire Miami Music Project. This 3-year-old nonprofit organization is keeping music alive in South Florida public schools, which have eliminated most of their music programs. Music education for children age 4 to 6 and an orchestral academy for children age 7 to 17 give them the opportunity to learn about and play music at no charge.
When you learn music, you learn discipline, you learn math, you learn history, you learn creativity, you learn how to communicate with one another.
Chandra Whitehouse drives her children, Eva and Jack, twice a week from Homestead to Doral so that they can participate in the program.
I just think music is a way of life. It's every day. It encompasses, I guess, in all the activities. And if you start off very young, it's ingrained in your soul. You become to love music and just adore it. And once you become older, it's hard to shake.
If we look around the world at where these projects, education projects, have been successful, music is something that absolutely brings our emotions together more than anything else in the world. That it doesn't matter which culture you're in, if you play a minor chord, or a sad chord, or a major chord, a happy chord, everyone's going to feel something of the same emotion. This fact is unique, I think, in the world. You know, that's what music is.
Eighth grader Kelsey Millian has been playing with the Orchestral Academy in Doral and just learned that she has been selected for the Honors Orchestra.
The violin is almost like me. Your instrument, you choose your instrument, but like it also chooses you. Like, what I love most about it is that you can show your emotion. You can, if you're feeling sad that day, you can play a sad song and like feel it, you know? You can show the audience, the people, that what you feel. Like, 'cause some people can't explain it in words, so you can explain it here.